atrial fibrillation is the most common heart rhythm problem in the world. Up to 1 in 3 people over the age of 45 develop atrial fibrillation. And one of the major concerns with atrial fibrillation is that it puts patients at increased risk of stroke. Patients are at about at a 5-fold higher risk of stroke, and about 5% of patients with atrial fibrillation will have a stroke. The data shows that about 50 to 60% of patients are treated with a blood thinner. And one of the main reasons that patients are not treated by their providers from other research that we've done is frailty. Providers are concerned that patients who have markers of frailty are at higher risk for bleeding events, they're at higher risk of falling and hurting themselves, and so those patients are often not treated with a blood thinner because the concern is that it shifts the risk-benefit ratio of the blood thinner. In our analysis, we labeled people as being frail if they had one of 5 different markers, and the markers were age greater than 85, a history of falls, a history of osteoporosis, a history of dementia, or a history of a high Charlson comorbidity index, which is a group of different characteristics that have been validated as labeling patients as being frail. And so patients had to have at least one of those 5 factors in order to be classified as frail within our data set. And I think one of the things that was incredibly interesting about the analysis that we did, we looked at almost 2 million patients with atrial fibrillation throughout the United States. And within those 2 million patients, 55% of those patients had at least one marker of frailty and were labeled as having frailty in this analysis. What we found within looking at patients who are frail and those that are not frail, among the patients that are not frail, about 53% of those patients were treated with an anticoagulant. And when you look at the frail population, it was considerably lower, and only about 40% of patients with a marker of frailty were treated with an anticoagulant. Now, that's a major concern for a bunch of reasons. One of the reasons that it's a major concern is that, again, that's more than half of the population. So since it's more than 55% of the population, more than half the population is much less likely to be treated with a blood thinner. The other reason that it's a major concern is that although providers are often concerned about higher risks of bleeding in patients that have markers of frailty, we also know that there's a much higher risk of stroke in the patients who have these markers of frailty. And so there are higher rates of stroke in the frail patients. And again, that's a reason that we especially want to focus on getting those patients appropriately treated with anticoagulants or blood thinners. What we found was that patients who had frailty and were not treated with an anticoagulant had higher rates of stroke and ultimately higher rates of mortality or death as well. And so the frail patients that were treated with an anticoagulant or blood thinner did have a meaningful decrease in the amount of strokes that they had, and they also had lower mortality. Maybe what's most important is that among the patients who were treated with blood thinners or anticoagulants who were frail, we didn't see a higher risk of hemorrhagic strokes or bleeds in the brain. And it's really bleeds in the brain that are the most concerning event that a patient can have on a blood thinner. And so the fact that we didn't see higher rates of those life-threatening bleeds, even in the patients that were treated, I think was really important for safety. If anything, these patients that have frailty and that are at higher risk of falls and fractures, if anything, those patients, maybe the data suggests, should be treated more often with one of the newer blood thinners. And in fact, our data shows that they're being treated less often with the newer blood thinners than patients without frailty.